These were the scenes at Superior Complex in Arua Park. Businesses locked and sealed off by Kampala Capital City Authority for defaulting in paying their trading licenses. Many traders sat idle outside their business premises as KCCA enforcers swarmed the building to verify those who had paid up. The exercise began yesterday, and by this morning, more than 200 shops were still closed down until their owners paid up their annual dues. KCCA's publicist Peter Kawuju said traders had been warned to pay up their trading licenses 2 months ago, and many had not paid heed, prompting City Hall to crack down.
We called upon the public, the business community, to move and pay their trading licenses. And indeed, we got a very, very good response. But there are also those who never responded, who will always sit back and wait to be pushed. So we have had no option but to move and ensure that they pay this money, which is due to government, so that government can provide the services that the people in Kampala need.
KCCA plans to carry out the exercise throughout Kampala, including its suburbs.
And we're not just in Central Business District alone, we're also moving in all divisions to ensure that shops mostly pay and are in compliance with the law as regards trading license.
Our appeal to the technical people is let them increase on the sensitization, awareness, let people know, because most traders downtown don't even whether their licenses have expired or not, so many of them lack knowledge.
But Kampala City Traders Association was unhappy at the action by KCCA and accused them of acting unfairly.
I think this is a desperate move by the Kampala Capitalist Authority. Let them sober up. We are already telling our members to pay, but they should not pay for past times, as we did not ask for what they collected illegally, and we mutually agreed.
David Katumwa, a local leader and preeminent businessman along the busy Arua Park hub, also weighed in with his accusations against KCCA.
Some of our traders, they paid in January. They received bank payment advice form from KCCA in January, February. To date, they have not received their license. Despite several reminders, KCC has not yet issued the license for those who paid 3 months back. Now we're wondering, how many years does it take for KCCA to issue our licenses?
However, by mid-morning, some businessmen, eager to get back to work, quickly paid up and had their premises reopened.